You probably learned that you should use FetchType.LAZY for all of your associations. It ensures that Hibernate initializes an association when you use it and doesn't spend any time getting data you don't need. Unfortunately, this introduces a new issue. You now need to use a join fetch clause or an entity graph to fetch the association if you need it. Otherwise, you will experience the N+1 select issue, which causes severe performance issues, or a lazy initialization exception. If you do that for multiple associations, Hibernate might throw a multiple bag fetch exception. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. In this video, I will explain when Hibernate throws this exception and show you your two best options to fix it. One of them is a great fit for associations with a small cardinality, and the other one for associations that contain lots of elements. So let's take a look at both of them and you pick the one that fits your application. But before we start, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. As I explained in a previous article about the most efficient data type for a too-many association, Hibernate's initial naming of the collection type is pretty confusing. Hibernate calls it a bag if the elements in your Java util list are unordered. If they are ordered, it's called a list. So depending on your mapping, a Java util list can be treated as a bag or a list. But don't worry, in real life it isn't as confusing as it might seem. Defining the order of an association requires an additional annotation and is almost always an overhead. That's why you should avoid it, and why at least 90% of the association mappings that use a Java util list and that I've seen in real projects are unordered. So Hibernate treats them as a bag. Here's a simple domain model in which Hibernate treats the reviews and the authors of a book as bags. If you try to fetch multiple of these bags in a JPQA query, you create a Cartesian product. This can create performance problems. Hibernate also struggles to differentiate between information that is supposed to be duplicated and information that was duplicated because of the Cartesian product. Because of that, Hibernate throws a multiple bag fetch exception. You can find lots of questions about this exception and various solutions to avoid it. But a lot of them come with unexpected side effects. The only two fixes between which you should choose are the ones that I will describe in the following sections. Which one of them is the best for you depends on the size of the Cartesian product that your queries might create. If all of your associations only contain a small number of elements, the created Cartesian product will be relatively small. In these situations, you can change the types of the attributes that map your associations to a Java util set. Hibernate can then fetch multiple associations in one query. If at least one of your associations contains a lot of elements, your Cartesian product will become too big to be fetched efficiently in one query. You should then use multiple queries that get different parts of the required result. As always, optimizing the performance of your application requires you to choose between different trade-offs, and there's no one-size-fits-all approach. The performance of each option depends on the size of the Cartesian product and the number of queries you are executing. For a relatively small Cartesian product, getting all information with one query provides you with the best performance. If the Cartesian product reaches a certain size, you should better split it into multiple queries. That's why I will show you both options so that you can pick the one that fits your application. Option 1. Use a set instead of a list. The easiest approach to fix the multiple bag fetch exception is to change the type of the attributes that map your too-many association to a Java util set. This is just a small change in your mapping and you don't need to change your business code. As explained earlier, if you now perform the same query as I showed you before to get the book with all its authors and reviews, your result set will contain a Cartesian product. The size of that product depends on the number of books you select and the number of associated authors and reviews. Here you can see the generated SQL query. To get all the requested associations, Hibernate has to select all columns mapped by these entities. In combination with the product created by the three inner joins, this can become a performance problem. Whenever you write such a query, you also need to keep in mind that Hibernate doesn't hide that the result set contains a product. This query returns each book multiple times. The number of references to the same book object is calculated by the number of authors multiplied by the number of reviews. You can avoid that by adding the distinct keyword to your select clause and by setting the query hint hibernate.query.passDistinctThrough to false. In this example, my query only selects one book and most books have been written by 1, 2, 3 authors. So even if the database contains several reviews for this book, the Cartesian product will still be relatively small. Based on these assumptions, it might be faster to accept the inefficiency of the Cartesian product to reduce the number of queries. This might change if your Cartesian product becomes bigger because you select a huge number of books or if your average book has been written by a few dozen authors. Option 2. Split it into multiple queries. Fetching huge Cartesian products in one query is inefficient. It requires a lot of resources in your database and puts unnecessary load on your network. Hibernate and your JDBC driver also need to spend more resources to handle the query result. You can avoid that by performing multiple queries that fetch different parts of the required graph of entities. In the example of this post, I would fetch the books with all their authors in one query and the books with all their reviews in a second query. If your graph of required entities is more complex, you might need to use more queries or fetch more associations with each of them. As I explained in a previous post, Hibernate ensures that within each session, there's only one entity object that represents a specific record in the database. You can use that to resolve foreign key references efficiently or to let Hibernate merge the results of multiple queries. If you take a look at the following log output, you can see that the lists returned by both queries contain exactly the same object. In both cases, the book objects have the same reference. When Hibernate processed the result of the second query, it checked for each record if the first level cache already contained an object for that book entity. It then reused that object and added the returned review to the mapped association. If you use multiple queries to get the required graph of entities, you avoid the creation of a huge Cartesian product. This reduces the load on all involved systems and makes it easier to ensure a good performance for all queries. But that not necessarily means that this approach is faster than option 1. You now perform more queries than before. Each of them requires a database round trip and creates some management overhead in the database. For example, to create an execution plan. Due to that, this option is only faster than option 1 if the size of the Cartesian product creates a bigger overhead than the execution of multiple queries. As you have seen in this video, you can solve Hibernate's multiple backfetch exception in two ways. You can change the data type of the attribute that maps the associations and retrieve all information in one query. The result of that query is a product. As long as this product doesn't get too big, this approach is simple and efficient. You can use multiple queries to fetch the required graph of entities. This avoids a huge product and is the better approach if you need to fetch a huge amount of data. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I left the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!